Mint Studio has a variety of manipulation tools when working with designs. These include Move, Scale, Mirror, Rotate, Align, and Arrange. Some of these you may rarely use in Mint Studio, but some of these you'll use quite often. On my stamp design page, I have a candy design that came preloaded with the Mint machine and some text I've typed with Vision font in the design store. To move an object to an exact position or by an exact amount, go to Object, Move. This opens the Move panel. I can move the selected object by an exact distance right, left, up, or down, or move its upper left corner to an exact position. To resize objects, you can open the Scale panel with this icon at the top, or it's also found in the Object menu. To keep an object proportionate when resizing here, keep the box checked for Lock Aspect. You might not want the aspect ratio locked if you're resizing something like a rectangle that needs exact side lengths. Use the inputs to specify exact dimensions and click Apply when ready. Use Fit to Stamp to quickly resize a selected object to fit its largest dimension inside the stamp size you have open. This both resizes and repositions the object so it's centered inside the stamp. Fit to Stamp is really handy, so you'll also find it down here along the bottom where the icon looks like a diagonal double arrow. To mirror a selected object, go to Object, Mirror, and you can choose right there to flip horizontally or vertically, or click Mirror Options to pull up the panel with more choices. In the panel, you can also mirror a copy in the specified direction while keeping the original in place. I'll just resize some of these a little smaller. To rotate selected objects, go to Object, Rotate. You have lots of options right here in the menu to rotate by or rotate to. Click Options to open the Rotate panel where you can also set a custom rotation. Or you can always freehand rotate an object by dragging its green circle on the bounding box. To arrange objects by lining them up with each other or centering, go to Object, Align. You can quickly choose what you want to do here on the menu. Center to Stamp is a great tool to have. For a more visual representation of what these choices will do, choose Align Options, which opens the Align panel. We'll cover this Align panel more in another video. Finally, if you find you need to move objects in front of or behind others, you can arrange those objects with a right click. With an object or objects selected, you can bring forward, send backward, send to back, or bring to front. For example, I've got this text from Acorn Dingbat's font open on my stamp, and I want to put a decorative wreath from my library around it. But it disappears when I open the image, simply because the image blocks it. I'll resize the wreath, then right-click and choose Send to Back. And now my text is visible again. Keep in mind, when trying to manipulate objects in Mint Studio, that most items in your library open as images with white backgrounds, so trying to layer multiple library images is not as simple as when using vectors with clear backgrounds. The vector objects with clear backgrounds include text created with the text tools, shapes drawn with the drawing tools, the original 50 Mint designs, and vector files you open from Silhouette Studio files. As you can see, you have a lot of options for designing stamps as you use the manipulation tools to your advantage. Thanks for watching!